Hi guys, Chris and PJ here live in the Dream Giveaway Garage.
Known as the Thumb. Hello everyone.
Ah.
We have a lot of fans out there, Chris.
Yeah, people write in. Can we see the thumb?
The thumb.
PJ.
The thumb.
PJ, usually I'd be holding something for Mailbag Wednesday.
No, but
not
this
today.
This is even better.
This is even better. So you guys
Not that we wouldn't take questions while we're live.
but this is, I've been laughing about this all day. You know how I feel about Cadillac's decision to not put the word Blackwing on the exterior of the CT5 and the CT4 Blackwing.
Which is their highest performance Cadillac.
Highest performance vehicle. You want to give it something to shout it out. Because when you're spending that amount of money, you want people to know that you're spending that amount of money on it. And when you're racing somebody, you want them to be scared that you've got a higher performing engine than they have. That's how it was in the 1960s. You'd look over, see whose vehicle was next to you, you know, at the stoplight, and you'd look at their fender emblem so you could see what size engine that they had. You guys remember? It would say on the emblem of a Chevy 427 or 454 in 1970 when the Chevelle LS6 came out, or 428 on a Mustang, or 455 on a 71 or a 72, actually 71 through 76 Trans Am. Huge bragging rights. So I get this today. I've got to read this to you. Hello team, and this is from our friends at the Cadillac V Club, and they're great guys.
This is Cadillac V Club.
Cadillac V Club. For those of us with the CT4V and CT5 Blackwings, one thing has been a consistent thread amongst us owners. Why are there no unique badging denoting our vehicles as V-Series Blackwings? We've been over this. We've shown you that there's only that little thing on the sill plate that no one can see. You have to open your door to even see it. So here's what they're saying. Well, Cadillac has heard the feedback and recently announced that 2023 models and beyond will incorporate a new Blackwing badge on the rear of the car.
What about cars that have already been out there with the Blackwing?
There's excellent news for them too, like the 2022 CT5V that we're giving away. They're going to mail the owners a new emblem that says Blackwing. After Cadillac has listened, I cannot believe it. General Motors has listened.
But we actually put Blackwing all over the place.
We put Blackwing all over ours. So maybe they saw ours and
What's it going to look like, Chris?
I'm going to show you. There's an image of it right there.
That's
so there's
logo.
A V, and underneath that it says Blackwing. Now here's
That doesn't seem like a huge call out to me.
It's not a huge call out. There it is on the back of the trunk. So I compliment Cadillac for listening to those of us who said they've got to put the word Blackwing somewhere on the exterior. Yet.
Oh, Chris, your love-hate with Cadillac is amazing.
It needs to be bigger. That's the only place they put it. But thank you, GM, and thank you, Cadillac. At least you put it someplace on the exterior.
Well, maybe they'll look at ours and
they'll look at ours and they'll say, you know, maybe we should offer a graphics option. And here I'm going to tell you a story of General Motors history. From 1970 to 1972, the Trans Am had a very small, we didn't even call it a screaming chicken. It was, that Firebird image. It was right at the crest of the hood. In 1973, Pontiac debuted the screaming chicken on a show car. But GM said, no one will like it. And the stylist said, everybody will love it. Everybody will want it. And what happened?
Chris wants every car with a screaming chicken on it.
Every car should have a screaming chicken on it. So what happened was everybody, by the mid-70s, everybody from Burt Reynolds and everybody in Smokey and the Bandit through Stallone in Rocky II, everybody had to have a Trans Am with that big screaming chicken bird on the hood. It became just, that's how you identified a Trans Am. Was that insignia, that big insignia on the hood. But GM didn't want to put it on the car. So they made it an option. you could spend an extra, I don't know, $30 or $40, whatever, in 1970s money, and you could get the Screaming Chicken on there. Or you could get the, you could do a hood bird delete, they called it, if you didn't want the hood bird on there. So why shouldn't a Cadillac now do something that bold and that dynamic with the Blackwing car? Why don't they come up with a screaming Blackwing that if you want it, you can put it on the hood? Now I'll tell you, some of you guys are gonna not like that idea, and some of you guys are gonna love the idea, but at least it's an option. Here's what we know. Cadillac is now putting the word Blackwing on the back of the trunk lid. And if you can read that, as small as it is,
Chris,
your eyes.
Before we go into today's live and looking at the wheels, you want to go take a look at
Go take a look at it.
All right, because that's.
And let's show where it's going to be. And let's remember, guys, that the Blackwing callouts are, these were all custom from the Dream Giveaway Garage. You see this Blackwing callout right there? That's not from the factory. That's custom from your friends here at Dream Giveaway. Now, we've shown you this before. That's blacked out. I'm going to remind you where Cadillac puts the word Blackwing. Got a magnifying glass? There it is, way down there. Now, PJ, you told me that it's also here on the seat, right?
Yeah, I think someone told me.
There's a V there on the seat. I don't see the word Blackwing on the seat. Someone is telling us that it's there, but I haven't found it yet. So, now, let's go back and look at the trunk. So here's the V. We black that out. So underneath there, and Cadillac is going to send this to us, probably with a love letter too. Cadillac's going to send this to us and go say Blackwing right under there. So thank you, Cadillac, for putting the word Blackwing on the exterior of the car. Now, make a screaming Blackwing for those of us.
Well, Mike,
you don't make the Trans Am, give us a screaming Blackwing.
Mike Brown says, yay, Chris got Cadillac to finally listen.
Woo! Okay, today we're talking about wheels.
Yeah, we are talking
about
wheels.
It'll be a real good show.
Mike Brown says, I had an 89 Firebird and got the Screaming Chicken decal, put it on it as it was an option.
That's correct. See, I tell you guys, I know all this stuff. Come on over here. We're going to start with the Ford F-100. People have asked us about these wheels.
All right, so today we're talking wheels on classics, right?
Wheels on classics.
Wheels on classics.
And tomorrow we're going to try to get to the late model cars. And try not to show anything in the reflection of this truck,
PJ. Yeah, it's okay. Easter eggs are okay.
Because there's like Easter eggs right near us.
So what do we got? F-100.
So these are...
1970.
Correct. So these are Goodyear Eagle GT2s. This particular tire is no longer available. So when they did the restoration on this, you could still get this at your local tire store. This is not considered a classic tire reproduction like the other Goodyears that you can get from Kelsey Tire. So if we look right here at it, we'll see that this is a 15-inch wheel. And this is a Ford 5-spoke wheel. You can buy them and they're aftermarket. They'll bolt right up. And they look fantastic on the F-100. You can also call this a mag wheel. There you go. Not mag as in magazine, I think.
Magpie.
No, I think magnesium. Is that where it came from? I got to look that up.
Kevin says, this is a wheel good show.
It is a wheel good show. And that's a wheel good comment.
Nathan says, just popping in to say hi.
Hey, Nathan, how are you, buddy? Nice to see you, Mr. Funhaver.
That's right.
Okay, now we're down here to the Monte Carlo SS with 1987 Monte Carlo. 600 miles on this. Now, here's what's interesting. This is a factory wheel. And they came on the Monte Carlo SS in 1987. This particular tire was still being made by Uniroyal. Goodyear no longer made this tire. Though Kelsey Tire makes a reproduction of them, but the pandemic has made them very hard to get. So this is a factory wheel. This one, you can see how clean it is. Not restored. Only 600 miles on that. And Uniroyal still makes this fitment. I think it's like a 225, 65, 15, or you guys can see it in there somewhere.
And that's on the 87 Monte Carlo.
That's on the 87 Monte Carlo. Now, let's go all the way back.
Before you go any further,
no, let's not go all the way back.
Before you go any further, Federico says, I can never get tired of all the wonderful cars in the garage.
Oh.
He's giving you a good run for your money.
Yeah, he's giving me a good run for my money. That's right.
Okay, 64 yeah. Corvette.
64 Corvette with the knockoff wheels.
Fuelie.
These are also called turbine wheels, but what's interesting on these is that these have reproduction. You can never get, you know, be of good riches this old to still be able to drive on. So these are G70x15 4-ply bias ply wheels. And look how narrow those wheels are. That's what people ran on their premium muscle machines back in the day.
That's dangerous.
These, of course, are called knockoffs. And you see how you got to look right there, where you show them where the word off is in the arrow?
Oh, yeah.
So that's to show you the direction that you knock on this cap to get that off, and then the wheel comes off. This was not a safe design. I think the federal government got upset at General Motors on it, and they had to change this design. So they still have them on collector cars, but for safety, they had to go to a better engineered wheel.
Didn't they just for safety go from a C2 to a C3 just because of
safety? They did that too.
All right.
Okay, so there we go. That's on that. Oh, while we're talking about second generation Corvettes, same thing on the 65 Corvette. We can't show it right now.
Oh, yeah, it's up in the back here.
Back here. But that also has the knockoff wheels. So that those are 15-inch classic wheels. If you guys have a favorite, shout it out. The Ford, the Monte, the Corvette. You know, they're all different era wheels.
Does it have a mallet, Larry West wants to know, to knock them off?
Does it come with a mallet?
I don't know, would you need just any rubber mallet, or would you obviously
use a so
hammer?
Here's a question. Cars with these, did they come with a mallet from the factory? I don't want to say yes, but I seem to recall reading something about it. I'm going to have to look that up.
I gotta assume the tire companies around the area, your local garage.
They probably kept one in stock. But I don't know if, like, you put a jack in the car, if these cars came with a little baby mallet to knock them off.
Calvin says no leather mallet, so yeah, maybe it was leather.
I don't know. Okay, let's get on over here to another fine Chevy from the finest decade to ever grace the
1966
Chevy 2 Nova. So you guys know that this car was restored to be, period correct, but it doesn't mean that these wheels are original to the car. In fact, I know that they're not. I'll show you why. So these are 14-inch Chevy Rallies. I have reason to believe that they're 14 by, were they 7s or 6s? Look like 14 by 6s to me. And here's why. It says disc brakes. And we know that the Nova has drum brakes up front. So somebody, you know, restored this with, they got a nice set of these Rally, a Chevy Rally wheels, which were available for 15 or 20 years from Chevrolet. And they put these on as part of the restoration. The tires are reproductions, they're from BF Goodrich. They're Silver Towns. They are available out there in the marketplace. But again, all four of these wheels say Chevy, a disc brake, and that's not how, this Nova was a four-wheel drum brake car. PJ, help! I'm talking about wheels and I can't get up.
That's funny. Only three more to go, Chris.
Three more to go. Okay, one of my favorite wheel designs of all time.
My favorite car in the garage.
Yeah. Pontiac Rally 2.
No screaming chicken on here.
No, not on the GTO. That was the Firebird Trans Am. This one, the Rally 2. So when the GTO came out in 1964, you could get it with hubcaps, you could get it with poverty caps. Like, remember that Impala that we had a year or so ago?
Yeah, it was just kind of basic.
By 1967, the Rally 2 came out. And that's the Rally 2. Ended up being the most popular wheel in Pontiac history. It was on everything in the 1970s, from Firebirds to Bonnevilles to wagons to Catalinas to Trans Ams to probably even Sunbirds. You could get Rally 2s on almost anything. They were so popular. So I've had many discussions concerning this. One of the things, so Pontiac in the 1970s also had a honeycomb wheel and had a snowflake wheel. And one of the things that bothered those of us in the Pontiac hobby is that those iconic wheel designs didn't translate over to the 16 and 17 inch fitments that started to occur in the 1990s on the Firebird and on the Trans Am. So there are now aftermarket versions of the Rally 2 and the Honeycombs and the Snowflakes that you can get in a 17 inch size. They look just like this, but when you see them, know that the factory never made them. It's an aftermarket solution because people demanded them. For whatever reason, General Motors and Pontiac never brought to production a 16 or a 17 inch Rally 2. You could get them in a 14 inch, you could get them in a 15 inch, and that was it. You could also get them with two different bolt patterns. You could get them in a small car bolt pattern like the Firebird or the GTO, or you could get them in a full-size bolt pattern like a Bonneville. The spacing on those lugs are different. One is called 5x4.5, the other is called 5x5. So probably more information than you need to know. But the Rally 2, absolutely iconic, and so nice to see it here. These are more modern BF Goodrich radial TAs, which are still available and are still in production.
Don Clark says, my driveway has a spot reserved for this GTO.
Yeah, there you go.
Mike Brown says, I love the GTO wheels.
And PJ loves this GTO.
I do. Lewis says, my first car was a Nova.
There you go.
I don't know if it was a 66 Nova, but...
Well, they made Novas for a long time, from the early 60s. When did they stop making Novas? 79, 80? Somewhere in there, you know, made them a super long time. Okay, two to go, guys.
Two more classic tires and wheels.
When you think of a Boss 302, you think of Magnum wheels like we saw on the Ford F-100. You think of those, but the original owner of this Boss 302 did not want those. He got the steel wheels with the basic caps. Those are just caps. So
right
there's
up.
A ring, there's a cap, and there's a steel wheel behind it. This isn't a sport wheel. This is a basic wheel. You probably could have gotten this on an LTD, PJ. But the original owner of this really liked that look, and that's why he got it. And this is, of course, a 15-inch wheel for 1970. On reproduction Goodyear Polyglass GTs, available from Kelsey Tire.
That's amazing. Correct. Yeah, I guess if you were trying to put a car together these days, you would need to figure out period tiring, right?
Yes. I mean, if part of your goal as a hobbyist is to have your car look like it looked in the dealer showroom, then that's a very important part of it. I will tell you guys that, you know, it is not cheap to do a car to that level anymore. So.
Or safe sometimes.
Well, or safe, like the bias plies on a Corvette. They do them, but those cars are primarily trailer cars. They drive those bias plies up 20 feet and down 20 feet. They don't take them on long trips because bias ply, there's a reason they invented radials, right?
Right.
There you go. One to go.
Mike Brown says, odd that the Boss 302 has hubcaps instead of Magnum wheels.
Well, that's exactly what I said.
Yeah.
The original owner specified. Remember, this was a special ordered car.
Yeah, so special paint too.
Special paint. So he specified no Magnum wheels, and no louvers, and no spoiler, and no scoop. And that's how he had it built. Back in those days, you could go option by option and either select it or deselect it. These days, because of the option packages that come with all the vehicles, it's much harder to do it. Vehicles are not as unique as they were in the 60s. Hmm. Okay.
Oh, our favorite, Charger 500.
Look at that. Well, definitely, they call this a Dodge Rally wheel.
Hey, wait, before we go into this, I want to talk about the paint color first.
Here.
No, here on the Charger 500.
R4, Charger Red, they call it. And they don't call it Charger Red because it's on this Charger. I mean, they call it Charger Red even if you got it on a Dodge Monaco. Called Charger Red Paint. R4 is the code on it.
So you could get any 69 Charger paint code on the Charger 500.
Absolutely. Any paint code that was available. You probably could even have gotten a special order paint, though I don't know if any were actually done that way. So yes. And I know that question has come up. Why are you looking at me like that, PJ?
Larry says, well, probably going back to the boss, Are the lug nuts original left thread, or is one side right thread and the other?
Oh.
I don't know.
That's a great question. And that brings up the whole question what Mopar was doing on its left thread, right thread thing back in the 60s. I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. There were safety concerns with that as well, and those were fixed. I'll have to get a lug wrench and figure that out for you guys and let you know. I don't know if that's been corrected or not.
Jonathan says, is the charger automatic or stick shift?
You come here.
Let's take a look.
Take a look, and you tell me. Does that look like an automatic to you?
Let me get a little closer here. Look at that.
PJ,
beauty.
It doesn't look like an automatic to me.
No, but it doesn't have a white shifter knob.
It doesn't have a white shifter knob.
With the seats being white, I think it would look kind of goofy with a white shifter knob.
I guess. With the white of mine, yeah.
So that looks pretty good the way it is now.
Looks good. So,
let's take
rally wheel. And let's take a look at what's it got on it. Oh my. So it has, this is a reproduction tire. The Silvertown radial, and this is cool because it's made to look like a classic bias ply, but it's a radial. So it is a reproduction red line radial. So this drives much better than a bias ply on here. And that, of course, is a factory wheel. The size hasn't been changed on that at all. So that's exciting. I like the way that looks as well on that five spoke. By the way, have you guys seen the new Dodge concept car, that SRT Daytona all electric that's going to be faster than a Hellcat? I can't wait till we get one here in the Dream Giveaway Garage.
Mike Brown says Classic Wheel Wednesday has been fun.
It has been fun. Tomorrow I think we're going to do Modern Wheel Thursday, and then on Friday we're going to have an award ceremony for the winner of the T-Rex.
And we'll do a fire it up later in the afternoon.
That's what we'll do. So let's wrap it up for today, PJ.
Alrighty, sir.
We'll see you guys tomorrow. More great fun, more great action, more great wheels, and a really good time. It only happens here in the Dream Giveaway Garage.
See you next time, everyone. Thanks for watching.